several colors. Being intelligent and capable of speech, it should not, strictly speaking, be termed a beast, but by its own request has been classified such by the Ministry of Magic. The centaur is forest-dwelling. Centaurs are believed to have originated centaur communities in many parts of Europe. Wizarding authorities in each of countries where centaurs are found are located area where the centaurs will not be troubled by muggles. However, centaurs stand in little need of wizard protection, having their own means of hiding from humans. The ways of centaur are shrouded in mystery. There are, generally speaking, as mistrustful of wizards as they are muggles, and indeed seem to make little differences between us. They live in ranging in size from 10 to 50 members. They are renowned to be well versed in magical healing, divination, archery, and astronomy. I'm also gonna get something to drink out of my hand dandy. Which one should we do? Let's do dragon. Mom classification XXXXX. Probably the most famous of all magical beasts, dragons are among the most difficult to hide. The female is generally larger and more aggressive than the male, though neither should be approached by any but highly skilled and trained wizards. Dragonhide blood are delivered and or all have highly magical properties, but dragon eggs are defined as class A non-tradable goods. There are 10 breeds of dragon. Though these have been known to inbreed on occasion, producing rare hybrids, purebred dragons are as follows. The Iberian Black, Hungarian Horntail, Norwegian Rideback, Bavarian Vapertooth, Roman Longhorn, Swedish Short Shout, classification X. The flapper worm lives in damp ditches, a thick brown worm reaching up to 10 inches in length. The flapper worm moves very little when it is indistinguishable. Why did I decide to read? Did I? I don't know. I'm sorry. From the other, both producing the mucus from which its name derived, and which Mm-hmm.